did during World War II?
Yes.
What did they do? And so that the IRS is heading in that direction?
Yes.
They're heading in the direction of killing a lot of people?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah, very serious. You know why?
Tell me.
Ration.
It's rationing.
They ration healthcare in Canada. If my comments were insensitive to people, that they were offended that I brought up the Holocaust. The Holocaust is probably a bad example, but Americans should not forget that it did happen.
I think if your question was this, do you think that the IRS is a criminal organization that is going to line people up and shoot them and hang them, what would the governor say?
No.
No. And I think that's the message. I think you've taken an interpretation of what he said to an unintended end. What I think he said and what I heard him say was that the IRS is in enforcing a law that forces people to buy something that they don't necessarily want, is not doing what is in the long and great tradition of the American Republic. That's what I heard him say.
He just said the IRS is on its way to being Gestapo.
I think you interpreted it differently, and I certainly interpreted what he said very differently than the conclusion that you drew.
Okay, so you have no problem with what you just said here.
I didn't say
that's not what he said.
That's not what I said. You see, I mean, again, you're drawing conclusions, Paul.
I'm asking
that is not. No, you're not. You are drawing leading questions and conclusions. That's not what he said. That's not what I interpreted. What I heard, and I, there's no point in repeating what I just said. That's what I said. But I said, you know, what Governor LePage stands on whatever he said, but what he said is not what I'm saying. What I told you essentially what I said.
Paul, you've got $100. You've got an 85-year-old person who's very ill, who's going to die shortly, and a 20-year-old who's ill and needs the same prescription as the person. Which one would you provide the medication to?
I would probably go to you and I would go to you and I would ask you those questions because you're the lawmakers and I'm just a journalist, so I don't make any decisions.
So why are you slanting my question? You're absolutely correct.
Uh-huh.
And that's my point.
Uh-huh.
My point is I try to make a comment to you that is a reasonable comment and you are slanting it so badly to give your spin, not what I said.
I don't think that turning around and making this about me is really the right way to approach this. I asked you a question. I gave you a chance to clarify your statements from last week.
What statement? What I said last week.
Mm-hmm.
Did you read my statement?
I did, yes.
Okay, what did it say?
I can't repeat it for you word for word. I wouldn't want to put words in your mouth. You tell me.
You see, what I'm saying is you're not being what I call an objective reporter. You're being a blogger.
What have I reported?
Well, your questions are clearly slanted.
My questions are slanted. I'm asking questions to you. I'm not reporting anything. I'll report something later on once I get back to my office and do that.
Do I think you can read that and judge my work at that point? Do I think that the IRS is intentionally going to kill someone? No. Do I think that the ACA is going to force rationing upon the American people? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if you know what rationing means, but I would research Canada and see if they have put limits on medical coverage based on age, based on diseases. That is the clear issue. Okay?
Great.
Thank you.
Let me just add, and I will add also, if you ask me directly,
yeah,
I believe the IRS are the Gestapo. I'd say no.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Simple as that.
No. I appreciate that.
But in terms of the questions that you asked, I think your questions were designed to produce a particular response as opposed to understanding the nuance of what was intended by what he said, at least, and that was my interpretation.
Okay.
Do I agree with calling people Gestapo? The answer is no.
Okay.
Clearly, we all have friends who make remarks that we don't necessarily find are remarks that we would make ourselves.